हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑन ज्ञान निकेतन ऑनलाइन क्लास। माई सेल्फ अमर राज, टुडे गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर फोर्स एंड प्रेशर, टॉपिक फोर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू कैन सी, पुश और अ पुल अप्लाइड ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट इज कॉल्ड फोर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू पुश समथिंग सम ऑब्जेक्ट और यू पुल इट, यू अप्लाइज फोर्स। So, the definition of force you will give, a push or pull applied on any object is called force. Force is a result of interaction between at least two objects. Say, suppose object A applies a force on another object B, then object B will also apply the same force, that is equal force, in opposite direction on object A. That is, force exerted by A on B will be equal to negative of, this negative sign shows opposite direction, negative of force applied by B on A. Force applied by object A on B will be equal to, but with negative sign, of force applied by B on object A. So it is said to be that force is an interaction between two objects, at least two objects. Here I have taken as example A and B. It should be any two objects. Their units of force, let us study about now units of force. Its SI unit is Newton. Newton is taken from the name of scientist, so its symbol is given by capital letter N. And CGS unit, the smaller unit, is dyne, symbol dyn. If you see the relation between Newton and dyne, 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. You can see 10 to the power 5, that is 1 lakh dyne. So this is the two units of force and the relation between them. Now see, let us something discuss more about force. As you can see, force is a vector quantity. Force is a vector quantity. Students, in physics, we study about different physical quantities. What are physical quantities? Let us know. The quantities which are measurable. Measurable quantities are known as physical quantities. And the physical quantities may be classified in two categories. One is vector quantity and another is scalar quantity. So force comes under vector quantity, because scalar quantities are those which have only magnitude, but vector quantities have magnitude as well as direction. So force has magnitude as well as direction, therefore it is a vector quantity. It means, to explain a force completely, you need its magnitude, that is a strength of force, that is value of force, and its direction in which the force is applied. Let us see an example. Suppose two forces acts on same body in same direction. First, taking in same direction, and we will see how direction is important. So in same direction, two forces acting on same body, suppose first is of 5 Newton and another is of 3 Newton. So the resulting force, that is F net. Net force means resulting force. The resulting force of these two will be equal to 5 Newton plus 3 Newton. It will give 8 Newton. That is the sum of the all the forces acting in same direction. Now, if the forces acts in opposite direction, if one force acts from this side, suppose 5 Newton, and another 3 Newton acts from opposite direction, then the resulting force, that is the net force, will be equal to 5 Newton minus 3 Newton, which will give 2 Newton. So students, you have studied about the direction of force, how direction is important. If forces act in same direction, their resultant will be addition of the forces, and if forces act in opposite direction, their resultant will be difference of these forces, and the direction of net force will be the direction in which greater force acts. The direction of net force will be the direction in which the greater force acts. So students, today we have studied about force, its unit, and about its vector nature. In next class we will study more about force. So for today, goodbye, best of luck for next class.